So Jenny and I have done something. We have bought a house that we are going to turn into a bed and breakfast.
So we bought this house for $225,000.
The house was built in the 1870s.
It sits on just shy of an acre of property.
The downstairs has one of the bedrooms up front, and then a living and dining room. And of course, the kitchen, a butler's pantry, and a bathroom along the back. Upstairs is where the other two bedrooms are, along with another bathroom and a massive closet.
You just walk in and you can feel the grandeur that once was. So our goal is to restore it to its former glory.
It's a huge job. We know it's going to take several months.
Yeah.
And we feel really confident about renovating the home, but we have no idea how to run a bed and breakfast. We have no one to answer to but ourselves. We also have to write the check, so that's also a little bit challenging.
We have a few bees that I do need to address.
Dang, seriously, what is that bees right there?
Well, it is raining. They don't want to go out in the rain either. They're just hanging out there. Maybe they're just chilling. It does look like there's honeycomb coming out of that column.
What are we gonna do? That's a lot of bees.
I don't know yet. We'll figure it out.
The house was listed as is.
If it's as is, you know there's something structural. There's either termites, bees in this case.
Seemed like a really good deal. We made a quick decision, bought it. Literally, we walked through the house in maybe 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Really, it's in fairly good condition.
We think.
It seems like a really good investment regardless.
We hope.
And I mean, it's a really cool old house with a lot of history that deserves to be restored and not torn down.
Steve's bees.
Yeah.
Steve's bees.
You're gonna help us with this problem.
That's what I hear.
Steve?
No.
He literally is the head of the Benton County bee chapter. So I feel like, you know what? Hey, yeah, there's a lot of bees up there, but we got an ace in the hole, and he'll take care of it.
Yeah. Are there two queens, like one over there and one over there, or is this all one?
No,
colony?
It's gonna be two separate colonies. Each colony has a queen, and
we're going through.
I have equipment. I have a bee vac that is made specifically for vacuuming honeybees out of these colonies. It doesn't hurt the bees at all.
Okay.
We'll transfer them from this into a hive.
Okay.
But as we're going through, we'll be looking for the queen. And so it's kind of, where's Waldo?
You know, the queen, is she bigger?
She is a little bit bigger. She's got a longer abdomen, but you're looking through, you know, it could be 50,000 bees looking for one.
Holy macaroni.
And so ideally, if we find her, I've got a little queen clip that I'll put her in. Oh. That'll make sure she's safe. And then we will put her back with her colony once we get them moved.
And they all come to her.
They will all come to her. Her pheromone, they smell that.
Oh.
So they will all be attracted to her.
She has a pheromone. It's rowdy. We would not be attracted to that pheromone.
David.
I've had bees in the past, and we've been just fine with it. Like, bees can be relocated. That's something that a lot of people see as a serious infestation, a serious issue, and it turns them away from buying the house, and not us.
I like honey, so I'll take bees.
Yeah.
I think we can move them, give them a bee box, let them do their thing, and then we can reap the benefits of the honey. I'm excited about that.
So we've got to cut a section out of the columns. So how mad are they going to get here in about 2 minutes? Furious?
When we get it opened up, just cutting a slot in it probably isn't going to do too much. But once we get it opened up, though.
For real, though, what do we do? Do you really have to stand still? Does that make them not sting you?
You might feel sweat running down your back.
Mm-hmm.
But if you feel sweat running up your back.
Oh, Lord, have mercy.
That's a bee.
Then.
Gosh.
Holy cow.
Oh gosh. Oh gosh. Oh my gosh.
All right. I'll get a ladder and I'll start cutting. I think that's all we can do.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll have to have it pretty much completely opened up before we can actually start removing stuff.
I'm going to go get the lift set up and I'll start cutting from the outside, I guess.
This is the stuff literally of nightmares. Like, I really thought, oh, they're so sweet. But then you look at them and you're like, they all have stingers on their butts.
Hey, Dave, you know, we're gonna just try to get the whole shell off the column, basically.
Okay.
Basically undress the whole column.
Just cut.
Okay.
Yep.
I got you.
Oh, gosh. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, babe, be careful.
Holy cow.
What, babe? What is it?
Oh, my gosh. This is, like, not good at all. I bet there's that much of that support column left in there. The rest of it's gone.
Oh, gone. My. And it's holding up the roof?
I don't know if it's holding it or if this concrete is partially holding it.
Oh, my gosh.
I got to get a support column cut and put under here right away. I'm not kidding. Like, it's, there's nothing here. Right. Nothing. So the bees from the bed and breakfast are going to be rehomed back at the bed and breakfast. But I need all of my bee frames here. And so we're going to make some new bee boxes for the bed and breakfast. But basically how it works, those bees, they have to protect everything inside that box. So there's beetles, there's all kinds of things trying to get in and steal the honey. And so you only want the box just slightly bigger than what these frames are.
Did you make those?
I did. I made a bunch of them a long time ago when I was doing bees. There's a little beeswax frame that's sliding down in there. Mm-mm. And then they'll build all their comb off of that.
Okay.
Bees literally make the world work. The food in our world, the flowers, the trees, like that happens because of bees.
I mean, they really don't bother me right now because I know we're not messing around with them. They're kind of keeping to themselves. They're doing their thing. It's fine. But I also know we can't leave them there because we will have guests.
So how many bees can fit in a box?
A good hive will be 20,000 in the winter.
That's a
It'll
lot.
Go shrink down and 80,000 in the summer.
So we can't have bees swarming our guests. But we can move them to a safe place on the property.
Yeah.
Give them a, you know, a bee box, let them do their thing, and then we can reap the benefits of the honey. Thanks.
Yeah.
I'm excited about that.
All right. I think we do different heights. So we'll build some smaller boxes too.
Sweet.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. There's our hive. There was our hive.
Woo, the bee guy's getting.
Well, Steve, that was not how it was supposed to go down.
Not how we planned it, for sure. But I had about 25 come up in my veil all at the same time, and I ended up, when I got in my car, I ended up scraping about 15 stingers out of my face. So.
Oh my gosh. So what do you think? Where do we go from here?
I think for now, we've got to kind of let them settle down. Right now, I've got so much alarm pheromone on me.
You can't do much of
that. They're all over me right now. But we're going to have to get that opened up and kind of spread out.
So, I mean, these bees, they left a lot of damage, a lot more than anyone could have foreseen. And you know what? We've got to push forward. We just tell our kids, like, hey, keep pushing forward, keep pushing forward. There is light at the end of the tunnel. I mean, this is a peephole. It's way, 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 way down there.
It's a very long tunnel.
We're running towards that light, and it just keeps getting farther and farther away.
It does. It's kind of like a mirage in the desert.
In the life of not a successful day, I think that one ranks right up there.